สวัสดีค่ะ Now we come to chapter 6 electrochemistry. In this chapter, the objectives are for you to understand the system of a galvanic cell and electrolytic cell in which you have to be able to identify the anode and cathode, what are the half reactions, what is the overall reaction, and anode cathode in galvanic cell and electrolytic cell are connected to the different side of electrode, the positive side, the negative side. And for the electrochemical cell, you have to be able to calculate the cell potential and determine whether a reaction is spontaneous or not. And then you have to be able to use the Nernst equation to calculate the cell potential for reactions occurring under non-standard conditions. And also, we're gonna see the relationship between the cell potential and free energy that will identify the spontaneity of the reaction as well. And finally, we're gonna see the relationship again on the equilibrium constant and the cell potential. The contents in this chapter consists of three parts as shown here. Part number one is about oxidation reduction reactions, or we can call it a redox reaction. This is the foundation of electrochemistry. Part two would be about the galvanic cells, or another name is called the voltaic cell. This is about spontaneous reaction produces current or electricity. The last part is about electrolytic cell. This would require an electric current or electricity to drive a non-spontaneous reaction. The whole picture of the contents can be seen in this diagram. Electrochemistry relate chemical energy and electrical energy. These two energy can be interconverted in galvanic cell or electrolytic cell. In the galvanic cell, the spontaneous redox reaction will produce electrical current. On the electrolytic cell, the non-spontaneous redox reaction will require electrical current to occur. Both of these two cells have two half cells. One is called anode, another one is called cathode. The anode half cell, the reaction that occur here would be oxidation reaction. The cathode half cell, the reaction that occur here would be the reduction reaction. Galvanic cell relate or have spontaneous redox reaction that show by delta G would be a negative sign, and E or cell potential would be a positive sign. In the opposite, electrolytic cell, that is the non-spontaneous redox reaction, this will show by delta G as a positive sign. E or cell potential would be a negative sign. Application or galvanic cell would be used in battery, where electrolytic cell would be used in electro-refining or electroplating. The reaction in electrolytic cell is called electrolysis. The galvanic cell would have that I said this already, standard cell potential or E0, and this E is related to the free energy and equilibrium constant. So here come together again equilibrium constant from the very first chapter and free energy chain or delta G in chapter 5. Standard cell potential is calculated from the standard reduction potential, and this used in the Nernst equation that you will use to calculate the E cell of galvanic cell or electrolytic cell. So we're gonna learn about all this. So let's see, what is electrochemistry? This is the study of chemical processes that cause electrons to move. So we're gonna have the movement of electrons or transferring of electron from one element to another in a reaction that is called oxidation reduction. In short, it is redox. Redox. R-E-D come from reduction. O-X come from oxidation. And this movement of electrons produce electricity. Let's see about redox reaction. In redox reaction, electrons are transferred from one substance to another. Another word, one substance is oxidized, another is reduced. So I make an icon to show you here. This would be the one substance that would like to give away its electron. So here it says, take my electrons, take my electron. And the another substance would be likely to receive electron. So it's been very happy to take electron. The losing or loss of electron by an element, the red one here like an angel, this would occur during oxidation. When substance lose electron, what happened is the oxidation number would be increased because electron has a negative sign, okay, losing negative out, so the oxidation number will be increased, it will become more positive. Where in reduction, reduction means receive electron, and this would be shown by the decrease of oxidation number. Okay, it will be more negative. Okay. In this reaction, magnesium would be called reducing agent. Magnesium would be called reducing agent because it gave away two electrons to reduce proton. At the same time, proton or hydrogen plus one is called oxidizing agent because it's oxidized magnesium. Okay. Reducing agent give away electrons, and this reaction is called oxidation reaction. Oxidizing agent receive electron, and this reaction is called reduction reaction. All right. Reducing agent is oxidized. It gives electron so that reduction reaction can occur. Okay. Another term that we can call reducing agent and oxidizing agent in some textbook, they use the term reductant and oxidant. All right. So in summary, about reducing agent and oxidizing agent. Reducing agent is a substance that would like to give electron. So X here would give electron. Give to who? Give to oxidizing agent, which very happy to receive or gain electron. When you say about the process here, you say that X is oxidized by Y. So X becomes more positive. Or you can say or make a statement that Y is reduced by X. So Y becomes more negative. The important thing that you need to consider is that in redox reaction, it comes together. So a reduction process must occur with an oxidation process. They come in pairs. A redox reaction can be described as two half reactions, and these half reactions are one reduction and one oxidation. Each half reaction is written to show the losing or gaining of electron. So reduction half reaction would show the gaining of electron, where oxidation reaction would be show the losing of electron. When we have two half reactions, we add them together, so we get the overall chemical reaction. And the very important here is that the number of electrons that lost by the reductant will have to be equals the number of electrons that gained by the oxidant. So give and take must be the same. Try this นะคะ You may pause the slide or video to try to answer all this. This is the reaction between zinc and bromine gas. The product are zinc ion and bromine ion. The question is, what is a reducing agent? What is an oxidizing agent? And can you write a reduction reaction? Can you write an oxidation reaction? Give it some time, นะคะ You may pause the slide and come back when you're done. Here are the answer. What is a reducing agent? The answer is zinc is a reducing agent. Reducing agent would give electrons during oxidation reaction. So you can write oxidation reaction straight away. Zinc becomes zinc 2 plus ion. So it means it losing or give away 2 electrons. Where oxidizing agent must be bromine gas. And bromine gas would receive electron in reduction reaction. Receive how many electrons? 2 electrons and make bromine ion. Number of electrons must be equal. Receive 2 electrons, give away 2 electrons. I hope you all got it right. And we can make another example of redox reaction like the one on this slide. If you put the zinc metal into the solution copper sulfate, the redox reaction occurs straight away like shown here. Zinc metal put into copper sulfate solution. What you see here, you get the deposit of copper on the zinc, so you see something like blackish. So the oxidation that occur is zinc losing electron, where copper ion in the solution receive electron and show out as a solid copper on the zinc metal strip. Redox reaction that occur directly like this would have no advantage. Lucky that the scientists in the past, they try to separate the zinc and copper sulfate out and still get the reaction occur. So make the advantage of redox reaction like this. The redox reaction is wonderful in which It can occur even though the two half reactions are separated. But this, you have to have something in the connection between them. If you have connection between them, the redox reaction can still occur, which means the transferring of electron is happening. The reaction progresses as the electrons flow over the electrical connection between the two half reactions. This flow of electrons will produce electric current that can be used to do work. So we get something out of the transfer of electron, and this is the electrochemical cell. We have two types of electrochemical cell. One is called carbonic cell, or another name is the voltaic cell. These two names mean the same thing. From the very beginning of this video, I show you that carbonic cell is related the spontaneous redox reaction and electricity. The reaction produces electricity. The opposite, electrolytic cell, you use electricity to produce a non-spontaneous redox reaction. We're gonna look at the carbonic cell or voltaic cell first. This is the second part of the contents in this chapter. The carbonic cell, the name come from this scientist Luigi Galvani, the Italian scientist. The voltaic cell come from this scientist Alessandro Volta. So he is the first person who observed something electricity or electrical in the frog. And this person is the first person who invented battery and the unit that call for the electricity is the volt. This is the picture I took from the internet. Alessandro Volta is the first who invented battery in about 1800. He used the what we call the voltaic pile that consists of pairs of zinc and silver discs. They separate by paper discs that soak in salt water. So everyone were amazed by this electricity that occurred. And this is the picture of the very first battery from the person John Frederick Daniel. In this battery, he used zinc and copper rather than zinc and silver as in Volta did. This is the picture from the museum, and this is the sketch of his system. So we look at the very, very first battery and look at nowadays. Batteries nowadays, we cannot, go by without using some kind of batteries. You must be familiar with this type of batteries or this type, the button type, AA, or 4A type batteries. This one you might not use very much. And we all use battery with all this equipment. Very familiar, right? Everyone use the laptop. Some of you have iPad, and calculator is very important. You use the watch, the phone, I will use the pointer. Everything here needs battery, And we come from, we use, take advantage of this technology so much that now the technology of batteries has been developed so much, and nowadays the electric car is will become very popular because of the reduce or decrease in the pollution in the air, and we don't need to use petrol anymore. What we use is the something like battery, lithium ion in the car. So many people would like to have this kind of car nowadays, but at least I want one. But anyhow, in this chapter, or what I will teach you is the principle or basic of the batteries or galvanic cell. So to take advantage of the movement of electrons, we have to separate the reaction into two half cells. So let's talk about half cell first. Half cell is something that you have consists of electrode or the metal that immerse in a solution that contain the ion of the same metal, or solution that somehow has ion that involved in reaction. So half cells consist of electrode and its solution. And each half cell, you have the equilibrium of reduction and oxidation. So you can get something like this: metal lose electron in oxidation, become metal ion. Or you can have reduction, metal ion receive electron and produce metal. So this oxidation and reduction is the reverse process of one another. Okay, you must have two half cells connected to get electrochemical cell. So you have to connect two half cells together, like shown here on this slide. This is one half cell. This is another, connect by external wire like this, and also connect internally by the saw bridge. One half cell would be called anode. Another half cell would be called cathode. You have to have the saw bridge to complete the cell circuit. Saw bridge can be something like this, like a U-shaped tube, or something like this, the porous disc, as long as you can have the flow of ions between the two compartments or the two half cells. Let's see in more details. Anode, half cell. This will be the half cell that oxidation half reaction occurs, where the cathode is the half cell that reduction reaction will occur here. Two electrodes, which are solid metal, two electrodes, are connected to external circuit. External circuit will be the path where electrons will flow from anode to cathode. Two half cells are connected by a saw bridge. Saw bridge would contain electrolyte or some ionic solution. And the ion in ionic solution are transferred between the electrode compartments by this saw bridge. Okay. So that when the oxidation occur, electron move out. In this solution will become more positive. When electron flow through the cathode, electron is used, so the cation here receive electron. Okay, this compartment will be less positive. Alright, so the ion in saw bridge will come into play. This one become more positive. So it needs a balance of a negative ion. The negative ion will flow to this compartment, where the positive ion will flow to this compartment to keep the cell as neutral as possible. Example of Daniel cell. Daniel connect zinc and copper half cells together. So the picture show you here, we have zinc metal immersed in a zinc ion solution. We have copper metal immersed in a copper ion solution. Two electrodes connected by external wire where electrons can flow between them. Two compartments are connected by saw bridge. Okay. At the anode, oxidation reaction occur in which reducing agent zinc losing electron. At the cathode, reduction reaction occur in which oxidizing agent copper ion receive electron. Adding these two half reactions together, we get this overall reaction. Zinc reactant react with copper ion. Zinc reactant react with copper ion. Produce product zinc 2 ion and copper. To consider which half cell is anode or which half cell is cathode. Anode is identified by the oxidation reaction. If oxidation reaction occur where, that is called an anode. Cathode is identified by reduction reaction. Where reduction reaction occur, that place or that half cell is called a cathode. In galvanic cell, the anode has a negative sign because electrons flow from it. In galvanic cell, the cathode has a positive sign. So the galvanic cell, you can well kind of memorize it, a trick to memorize it like this. Reduction is the cathode. So we have a red cat. Reduction is cathode. The opposite, oxidation is an anode. So we can have an ox, an anode, an ox. So we have red cat with an ox. Well, hope you get it. So try this. Try to sketch and label galvanic cell. It is said here, a galvanic cell is constructed from a half cell in which cadmium rod or cadmium metal dips or immerses into a solution of cadmium nitrate, with another half cell in which we have silver metal dips into a solution of silver nitrate. The two half cells are connected by saw bridge. And when you connect the two half cells together, silver ion is reduced during operation of the galvanic cell. Draw a sketch of the cell, just like in the previous slide. And then with the sketch, label the anode and cathode. Also show the corresponding half reactions, which means what is your oxidation, what is your reduction, and indicate the electron flow in the external circuit and the sign of electrodes. So take some time to try to draw this. Naka, you may pause the video and come back when you are done. right? And you should start to draw it and get the result like this. Cadmium dipped in cadmium nitrate. Silver dipped in silver nitrate. And you know that silver ion is reduced, which means silver ion receive electron. Obviously, cadmium will lose electron. Okay, and you know that this is the reduction, this is the oxidation. So which one is the anode, which one is the cathode? Cadmium half cell would be anode because oxidation occur here. Silver half cell would be a cathode because reduction occur here. Get the sign. Anode would be a negative side. Cathode would connect to a positive side. And electron will flow from anode to cathode. Alright? You still have more things to answer. What is the overall reaction? This is the overall reaction. So you add these two half reactions together and remember to balance the number of electrons. Cadmium give 2 electrons. Silver must receive 2 electrons, which means you have to multiply 2 throughout the equation. So you get cadmium plus 2 silver ion and make cadmium 2 ion plus 2 silver solid. So hopefully you are now can connect the two half cells together and show what you did between about the connection between two half cells. However, rather than having to draw a picture of beakers with solution and electrode, the metal strip, and connect everything, it would be more convenient to just write a shorthand notation, and this is called a cell notation or cell diagram. You just show what is your anode and what is your cathode and how you connect the two together. The convention of how to write a shorthand notation, the agreement is that you must have anode on the left side and cathode on the right side. So if you write the notation in this way, zinc would lose electron and produce zinc ion, and this would be your anode half cell, and oxidation reaction occur here. And when you write it like this, copper ion receive electron, become copper, and this is your cathode half cell, and reduction reaction occur here. These two half cells connected together by this saw bridge, and the flow of electron would be from left to right or from anode to cathode. In the half cell, if we have the phase different like this, solid phase and liquid phase, we use the phase boundary to show it as a single vertical line. As well as in cathode, we have the different phase between the liquid phase and the solid phase. So we show it with phase boundary, single vertical lines here. Okay. Remember again, anode on the left, cathode on the right. This is the example that we did together before, right? Rather than having to draw a connection of cadmium half cell with silver half cell like this, we can show the connection by the cell notation. The pattern that you seen just before here. Change this drawing into the cell notation. We know that the silver is the cathode, so it will be on the right side. Cadmium, however, is our anode, so it will be on the left side. So you're gonna change this drawing into the cell notation, and you will get something like this. All right, anode on the left, cathode on the right, and the cadmium and silver would be the terminal or the connection to external wire for electron to flow between them. And cadmium will lose electron and produce cadmium ion, where silver ion will receive electron and become silver solid. In the cell notation, you do not need to balance the charge between them. But if you want to show the reaction between these two half cells, you have to show it in a complete balance chemical reaction. Don't forget to balance number of mole of silver ion and mole of solid silver. The reaction is between the first one of each half cell. These are your reactant. The second part of each half cell would be your product. So it's very convenient to see what is the reaction from the cell notation. You have to be able to do the change from reaction to cell notation and cell notation back to chemical reaction. Sometimes the reaction does not involve the metal terminals. So for example, the reduction reaction of proton receive electron and produce hydrogen gas here does not have the metal solid involved. So when the half reaction involves gases and solution like this one, an inert material such as platinum serves as a terminal. This would be the electrode surface on which the half reaction occurs. The platinum is an inert material, so it will not get involved in the reaction. So you see the reduction reaction here does not have platinum in it. And also, if you have reaction between two ions, do not have phase separation between them. These are in the same phase, liquid phase. So we do not use a single vertical line, but rather use just a comma. This right in this direction means reduction from iron 3 to be iron 2. So iron 3 receive electron and produce iron 2 charge. Sometimes again, to actually show the full specified galvanic cell, we must include the concentration of the solution, like this one in particular, zinc ion solution has a concentration of 1 molar, and also a solution of proton has concentration as 1 molar, as well as the pressure of the gas. This one, hydrogen gas, has the pressure of 1 atm. Zinc and platinum serve as electrode terminal. Electron flow from the terminal, all right?